In this video, we're going to talk about spill equipment, what it is, how it works on land, on sea, and how you might use it in environmental management. G'day Brett, how are you?
Very well, thank you.
So let's talk about environmental equipment. Let's start super big picture. What are we talking about here?
Spill control equipment, we're talking about chemical spills, we're talking about HazCam spills, we're talking about spills in the water and sea and oceans and on land.
So we've spoken about using booms to contain spills. I appreciate that I'm quite ignorant here. Tell me, what is a boom and what are the different kinds that are available?
Okay, a boom is something that floats on water. It has a draft and a skirt, so there's some that floats above the water.
It's kind of like a long tube or pipe, if you will.
A tube or pipe full of foam covered in PVC. So with the skirt, that holds the oil from going under, and the foam stops it from going over the top of it. So it's definitely used for containment.
Okay.
We also have inflatable booms that can be inflated as they're taken over. This is better for if you've got 200 or 300 metres on board. They can be kept on a reel.
Right, I see. So it's, so to speak, store it small and then expand it as you need it.
It's storage, and then as you take it out, you inflate it.
Okay. Yep. With a bunch of guys at the side with a tube. Just
yes.
Presumably there's a pump involved.
A blower on the blower
on the
backpack.
Okay.
So they blow it up as it goes.
Okay.
And then after booms, you've got the skimmers. So once you've contained it, an oil skimmer actually takes the oil off the water and brings it back on board ship or back onto the land.
So that you throw out into the ocean and it travels around and picks up the oil, as it were.
It actually floats around in the oil, spins and takes the oil out of the water.
Okay, good. Let's talk about other forms of equipment that are used on land. You certainly mentioned booms, but you mentioned some other equipment as well. What might be used on land?
On land, you've got pads. We sell a pad that is hydrophobic, so it takes on board oils, but it won't take on board water. It'll float around on the water, take the oil out of the water, but doesn't absorb the water as well.
Different kinds of pads? Are there some inflatable ones?
No. A pad is just it's needle punch technology. It's like a cotton.
Right.
That absorbs oil.
Okay, so again, these are things that you should keep on hand to deal with spills.
Yeah, pads. Floor sweeps are another essential. Floor sweeps, again, absorb oils, so they can be used to remediate soil. So if a hydrocarbon gets into the dirt, you can put the floor sweep on. It'll actually, there's a bug involved that'll, it lays dormant until it's attacked by oil, and then it comes to itself and it bioremediates the soil by disposing of the oil.
So let me ask you, when it comes to a real life story or an anecdote, you've probably seen quite a few things come around. What are some of the more, I want to say, dramatic and possibly less prepared spills that you've heard of that you guys might have been involved in?
One of the largest one was the one in the Gulf of Mexico. The deep water horizon, you've probably heard about it.
Yeah, I think it hit the news at one point or another.
Yes, yeah, certainly did. A lot of our equipment was used in that spill.
Is that right?
And there was mechanical and small amounts of dispersant, but in situ burning was the big one there. Because it was so far away from land, and it was also the volume of oil. Mechanically, it couldn't have been picked up, so in situ burning was used in that situation.
So very good for the news cameras.
Absolutely, yeah.
All right, good. Thank you so much. For those of you who'd like to find out more, please join us online at bulbeckenviro.com.au or just reach out, send us an email, give us a call. We'd be more than happy to help and to answer all of your questions.